This is Alekius, and welcome back to Ultimate Admiral Dreadnought. I had quite a response from the episode before that, for this exact ship, which we're going to take exactly as I had it. Within limits, as I do see the weight is slightly different. So is the cost. I can't get it to match exactly, so I don't know exactly what was different. I reviewed the video. I don't know why it's different. It is identical in every way that matters. We have the 26.5 knots, 75.5 kilotons, very short, max, turbines, coal induced, hawk shaft, triple hull, anti-flood, reinforced, bulkheads, super heavy, like, everything's the same. But, for some reason, it's not identical. It's really close. It's off by, like, $100,000 in cost and a couple dozen tons. But I digress. We'll go into the match and start right away with the battle. And they appear to be that away. Which I'll actually reduce it down to times 5. Maybe even times 3. We're shooting. We're outside of range though. Got 2 hits so far. Like we were aiming at one of the light or heavy cruisers. Ooh, yeah, that's significant. Oh, I thought I'd selected it. We'll just close, continue to close directly until we get within range. I do like that if you give enough space for the turrets to traverse, they can spin full 360 degrees. They don't have to go all the way around to switch sides. Similar to the German K-class cruisers. Alright, appears to have some right bearing drift. Follow our mark for now. And just go to casemate. And bounced. Percent chance of hitting at this range. We'll come to starboard and see if we can't get that rear turret to fire. And destroy the main gun. Their number one turret. There we go, all three turrets. And just a partial pen. Couple of hits on that one, including some flooding up forward. There we go, I've selected it now. Throw it a secondary gun. Now at 12.5 kilometers. Probably about max protection for them. Oh, destroyed another main gun. Oh, no, destroyed the same main gun. Unless they switch targets again. Slow down the times too. There's a lot of shells in the air. Oh yeah, there we go. Got two main guns. Funnel, conning tower. Fairly disabled at this point. Probably switch to that one. This one is almost no threat. Alright, we have destroyers at close range. We'll come to starboard for torpedo avoidance. Ammo detonation on this destroyer. One of the branches did that. I don't know, there's a lot of hits on the destroyer. You'll note I'm not slowing down at all. It's because we have 100% accuracy with the main guns on who we're firing at. Yep, disabled a bunch of her main guns. No hits that time. There we go. Amount of damage. is she? Well, looks like we've only managed to disable one of the turrets. It's okay. Welcome to port. Oh yeah, we can switch to AG if we're shooting at destroyers. We will slow down. The destroyers are hard enough to hit. Not that they're that hard, I could stay at max speed. A couple salvos and they'll be gone. Got one of the funnels. And gun went through one of the funnels, it looks like. Maybe. No, it was a 3-inch. Salvo, and there's the hit, dude. That destroyer from the starboard slightly. We'll have to range with 18s first. So we'll only get one turret firing this time. Oh, there goes some torpedoes. These torpedoes. Why don't she switch targets? I guess I didn't have her fully manually targeted before. Ooh, wrong one. Ooh, more torpedoes. Got the full set out here. Gonna be rough. We're gonna take a second one. Keep coming to port. Tension damage isn't too bad, actually. Like, it hasn't slowed us down much. Thank you. a new target? Sure did. Outstanding. Let's keep coming to port. He's getting into a launch position. Much closer range than I did the first time, so I'm sure we'll take more damage. Hail 14-inch fire from these heavy cruisers? That was 14 inches. Oh, the Sviata. It's two different battleships. Destruction. Switching to HE. Just for the last little bit of damage we need. Cruiser, come on. And that takes care of that one. Now we switch back to AP. Do these cruisers have torpedoes? They do. There's our ranging shot. There's a torpedo. Might take a third on the stern. Burden not to, as that will damage our rudder. Ah. It hit, but the damage was minimal to the rudder. So we still have our maneuverability. This is very similar to how it turned out last time. I checked to make sure I have plenty of space on my hard drive this time. As embarrassing as that was. Last time we didn't get this close. I think we ended up at like 60% structure. We still had the damaged engine due to a torpedo. That's why I say this is pretty similar, just at much closer range. There's the ammo detonations I was expecting. That one has no torpedoes, no torpedoes. That one has torpedoes. And it fired it too. Yeah, maybe not. That might be from the other one. Oh, there's a torpedo. Where did that come from? Must have fired it just before they sank. There we go. That's a good amount of damage. See the torpedo that they fired, which is why I maintained that turn for a little while. And fire flooding, destroyed torpedo, more fire flooding. One fired yet? Yeah. Go to the main battery, and there we go. Another torpedo that has fired. That's not it. There it is. Like we'll take it on the bow. Dong. Ooh. There's the other one. About to fire our main guns. There we go. this point, there's the last torpedo, nothing to avoid. I'm going to accelerate time just to finish this up. I don't think there's any question. Pretty significant hit. Almost led the whole ship on fire. Ooh, she might flood out with that compartment. Oh, she's definitely done now. She'll burn. Which targets? A rare sinking to flooding. And there we go. So we took a lot more damage in that one, but we got within, what, 3 kilometers at one point? Things I am curious to try. Our towers. Our single funnel. I even really need the barbette. Oh, what is something crazy we can do? Now we had 43 inches of penetration with the 18, which was plenty. We have a Mark V there, does 30. Twelve is barely any less. Drops off rapidly from there. Nope, can't put him on the big barbette. That's just fine. Because I can do this. There we go. Can't fit the 777s, can we? Oh, we can. Why not? We'll do a full triple. All triples all day. I'm not gonna bother with the threes. Bow launcher, couple side ones. Why does it not duplicate the secondaries on this one? There we go. Do the turbines. Loadability. Just do the oil. Force. Maximum engine protection. Reinforced bulkheads for that 20% fire extinguishing and less chance of fire. Same for the anti-flooding. You saw we took torpedoes. I don't do the anti-torp protection though. It weighs way too much. Like, it weighs a lot. Although I have a lot of extra weight now. Or we'll carry plenty of torpedoes. Things to do. We'll go with the Lyddite. We go with high TNT. Maintain the penetration, but still get a lot of the HE fire chance. No need for quick traverse. And maybe a single. Blue standards, 20 inch. Actually, a single ship, we shouldn't really need the radio range finder. Or direction finder. Use that. Oh yeah, so much weight. It's amazing. Let's see, we were doing 25, 25, 5.2, 5.1, 25, 25, 5.1, and 5. Throw 25 on there. Finally gives us more weight. Doesn't cost us too much. Forced is non-optional as far as I'm concerned. Well, save a bit of money by going with Krupp 1. Yeah. What does the maximum look like? I don't think we can get that to not cost a lot. Oh, let's go with Krupp 2. Not too terribly more. Do 30, too much. I'll fix that in a second. Oh, 30, 30. I don't know, I kind of want to go nuts. This again, turning rate, acceleration, repairs, water pumping, things I want. But you know what? I'm going to sacrifice it. Need the weight savings. Go expensive again. Get rid of the triple hull. Get rid of the flooding. But we don't need increased ammo. Auto loading is costing us a lot, isn't it? Adar does as well, but we'll be fine without. Bring it back down. Squeeze that turret in there. Sacrifice the 5-inch. And the 7-inch. We're at Krupp 4, excellent. Not that those matter anymore. Oh, the other side. That doesn't matter anymore, does it? All right, perfect. All right, yeah, that's too much. There was a click in there. Come on, you can do it. Come on, 72,000 and a half. There we go. Nailed it. All right, they're that way. I'm running a little short on time, so I'm going to keep this battle as fast as I can. More of an experiment anyways. Go. Initial is pretty poor accuracy, which I chalk up to being 13-inch rather than 18-inch. The extra range that they have seems to scale very well. Oh, it's a visual box. Yeah, I'm going now to the corner. There we go, there's the forward turrets. Started a fire. As we approached within 12 kilometers. There's another fire. Far bad damage, not a big deal. pushing targets, really. They stay with the target. Up to 27%. There we go, whole slew of hits. Let's see, what do we got here? To let her burn if the destroyer is getting within five. Nice 10%. Still have a lot of speed though. Oh, there we go. Hard port, she launched torpedoes. I'd say she's probably done. Switch to the Katsuragi. There are the torpedoes. Oh, those are a couple really good hits. After the Udachi next. Maybe we'll just keep turning. That was a good one. Salvo, and that takes care of her. Switch back to the Kisaragi, finish her off. There we go. Now the Isokaze. Which has done her launch. and gotten away with it. Tamanami is not done for. Not yet. Oh, now she is. Torpedo launchers reloaded. There we go. Did manage to launch. Are they 4.5 kilometers? Which to AP. Get up to full speed. One decent penetration, mid deck. Yeah, it's still not good enough. I see, this one has Krupp 4, 16 inches. So we'll need to be 2,500. Here we go. And notice how slowly we accelerate without the shaft, the aux machinery, and our funnel completely damaged. Shift our rudder. Oh yeah, plenty of damage. I'm gonna have to switch targets. We have more torpedoes approaching, and we have no torpedo protection on this. Oh, and she turned broadside. Switch back to the Choge. And we're getting a few bounces at that range. Enough penetrations too, though. It's interesting to evaluate the difference between HE and AV. Meanwhile, I'm taking penetrating hits from this 15-inch. Oh, actually... no. Man, I miss having the report log. See it, it's there. Completely disabled at this point. just get broadside. Target of opportunity, which I know I skipped that one when it was passing. Traverses. No avoiding any torpedo if they decide to torpedo. Most of the lower decks are already damaged though. Here comes the broadside. Getting ready for another broadside. There we go. Shoot that one. Are you crazy? There, that's better. Plenty of flooding on this one. Might flood her out. That poor compartment's still flooding. Oh, she'll definitely flood out now. Alright, let's switch to the Nokogiri. Abysmal accuracy at this range, but you can see all the negative modifiers we have mounting up. some flooding there. There we go. A little bit more flooding. Our rudder is finally amidships. Now starting to turn port, finally. A little more flooding, not enough. Is that enough fire? One more salvo won't go amiss. I'll probably just outright take care of her. Oh, nope. That one was fairly inaccurate. There we go. Got a hit in the right place. Five inches of armor. That's nothing. Enough to get some overpens at that. Only two ammo detonations. Nope, don't switch targets. Fruitcake. Yeah, that's a fair amount of flooding. Midships again. Flooding in a compartment that's already flooded. Thank you. No, I'm fine with that. Gotta get ready and go to work anyways. Thank you for joining me. I appreciate you staying till the end, although I might split this out to a separate episode. We'll see. Anyways, please leave a comment, let me know what you think, and I will see you next time. Take care.